ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of Pastiche of Skin, where we're playing World of Final Fantasy.
World of Final Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy.
Yes, we're playing World of Final Fantasy. We're on to chapter 13 now. So we've got another 9 chapters left. No, 7, 8 chapters left to go. This is going to be fun, but we're going to try and hammer through these as fast as we can so we can all get them done in time for Final Fantasy XV's release. So what have we got left to see? We've just actually defeated the giant Flan with snow, and we're working our way out of the swamp mire, and we're moving on to the next location. I really want to get back to where our main map actually was, so let's say so long to the swamp. Alright, where have we got to go under? This is the way out. I'm assuming the Flan had increased the water because it was actually, so big of a certain size, and it was actually causing... what do you call that law whenever you actually put an object in water and it displaces the volume? Whatever it was. I'm pretty sure that's what it was called. Well, not what it was called. That's what the action is. But I don't know what you actually call the law.
I guess we're doing this.
Come on, bring it!
More Flans! Guess what? It's lightning time! Thunder! Thunder! Thunder Flan! Go away! Oh, god damn it. That's right, because I still don't actually have... Alright, let's see if we can just attack. We'll try and get rid of any one of these Mandragores with a punch. Yeah, that's good enough for me. Oh, you sick and dirty bile-throwing bastard. Thunder on the Flan. Weak. Weak! Down with you two. And just get a little hit from a Mandragore. Dead! So very dead.
Did it!
Oh,
wait! Ba 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 bam 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 bam. So, Smokey Joe's jumped up to level 12 there, so we might actually be a reasonably competitive choice now for a large creature. So let's see what he's got in his Mirage board. Let's see. What was it? Mirage board for Flan! Oh, not for Flan, for Smoky Joe! Let's jump into his board here and see what points we got. Tentacle. Here we go, physical damage, right? And defense plus. We have to work our way through this first branch here. We're taking for a joyride, but nah, I don't really care about having that. We've got 3 points left, so HP plus. And entropy. Randomly raises or lessens the top of strength of attacks. Oh! Okay. That could be useful. Or we go the way of accuracy, magic, critical guard, and then bad breath. Or we go entropy, strengthen. Oh, Asuna? Yeah, we're going that way. We're going up towards Asuna, because that's going to be an unbelievably useful skill as we get further into the game, and we're going to get hit by more stats effects. Oh, you son of a bitch! Just short by a point, so we'll need to keep him around for another wee while before we can get that. Then we got blank space, and then by the time he hits level 17, we'll find out what that new creature can be turned into is. But yeah, that's what our main goal is. We're going to get Asuna with us on the next level. Sorry, folks, that was actually very much annoying me. I wasn't going to be able to press buttons properly. Right, let's see. I don't think we need anything. Oh, do you want to need to do? I'll drop a wee ether on my character there, just so that he can actually use more skills. Have him ready for it, because I don't want them to actually have the possibility of running out of AP in the next fight. Other than that, we continue on our blind quest. Is there anything on the map to find? Nope, there's actually just an empty space, so we're just going to go the way we were going, into the red... Oh man, this is cool, because just by looking at this, I got a feeling that we're going into the canyon, and we might run into Red 13, which is one of my favorite characters from Final Fantasy 7. Or Aniki, was that the name of the character whenever they actually went back to his real name? Alright, Flan. Fall, you Flan! Death to Flans! Ugh. Thunder! 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 Oh! Whoa, no, don't want to attack. We want thunder. Down you go.
Well, that ought to do
it. Good job.
Smoky Jewel's up to level 13. We can get that as soon as Jewel, and we can throw it onto one of our characters, which I'll be probably throwing onto, who's it going to be? It's probably going to be Lan, if you think about it. She's the one that's actually got the space free, I think. Because she's got, Siphon. Alright, can we go for that skill now? Now we have enough points! Woohoo! As soon as Jewel it is. So, Mirror Jewels. We go to Lan and give him the Asuna. So he's essentially, Lan's unintentionally becoming our healer in a way now at the moment, because I've got Cure on him and I've got a Cure up because I have the Cure Jewel on him and then Cure on, I think, Fisty McFisterson.
Chapter 13. Castle in the Desert.
Let's go find that castle that's in the desert.
Rain.
Yeah? What?
This whole adventuring thing is hard.
Oh, you whiny little bitch.
Adventure? It used to literally mean bad stuff happening to you.
Thanks for the uplifting bit of trivia.
Wait! I can hear some activity over that other way. I think we're not far from a place to the rest.
A caravan!
I'll take the vibe over there!
Ooh. The caravan kind of reminds me of Final Fantasy 12, just like tended to actually see kind of like traveling caravans and stuff. Let's see if it actually is a character from it. Let's find out.
You there, giant pear. Listen, listen, you're here to get just the right time any time. I've got a problem, so lend me a hitty hand. Whoa.
Fishes of Morizum, Nizzle.
I'm not gonna bite. I'm just a merchant with a bitty bit of a ubiquitous streak. I need some of these thingalings so I can make some nice accessories.
Well, that sounds good.
Say delay. Want to help any dump me out? There'll be a
Okily
Dokily reward involved.
Three dragon wings.
Yahooty hooty hoo. I'm so glad I asked you for help. We merchants are too busy chizzy to do everything. Good luck
luckety-duckety.
With the searchity search.
Taking care of the busyness. Alright.
Yahoo.
Let's see if we've got... Do we actually have dragon wings? Because I think I got something that was similar to that, so we'll check the adventure log and see if it fits in. We've got some quests here that we haven't actually been able to do anything for. We can't trade any of these in. We don't have... What is it we're looking for? Dragon wings, dragon scales, or cactars. So we got some hunting to do if we're going to finish off any of those. So they probably... You get dragon wings while you're here in the desert, so that's kind of useful. So we got location here and location here. We'll go to the closest one first and see where else we gotta go. I'm just wondering, is there anything else that was actually in there? Because that caravan seems to actually have a exit as well. Can we go into the caravan? Yeah, we can! Alright, I was curious there because I was like, wondering whether or not it was just the guy on the outside that we could speak to. So, looking at the caravan. Oh, there's a door. Thank God there's a door. Okay, now I can go and do some item shopping.
Excuse me? Would you mind if we rested here a bit?
Sure. You can stay just as long as you like.
As long as you get leisty?
Just look at you two. You'll get baked alive out here dressed like that. Wait right there.
Aw, yay, we're gonna get a change of clothes.
Here, some sunscreen. Help yourself.
Class of 99.
Please.
If I had one piece of advice for you, it's sunscreen.
Sunscreen force fields applied and activated.
Thank you so much.
Force field. You are a living derp, aren't you, Lan? That poison I put in the sunscreen will hit them soon.
Now I'm all lathered up. I can smell.
Smell what?
Mirages.
The bullshit. Over there. Oh, Occult Fan, issue 3! Yay! Okay, so, for anybody who hasn't been watching the series all the way through, Occult Fan... Wait. We started issue 2? Alright, that's okay then, because I hadn't missed one. I was wondering there, I thought I'd missed one of them going from issue 2 to issue 3. But, issue 1 to issue 3. So, Occult Fan is actually written in the world of Final Fantasy by Biggs and Wedge. A standard character in the Final Fantasy series that actually appears in every single iteration. So let's see what they've got to say in this particular issue. Many of our readers will have visited the Phantom Sands. This famous desert seems to offer the same scenery in succession no matter which way you go. But have you heard the rumors that proceeding correctly will take you to an oasis? Well, the desert may have sand, but so do we here at Occult Fan. We decided to head to the scene and sift through the story ourselves. On we trudged amidst sweltering heat, but sure enough, soon one dune was starting to look very similar to the next. We couldn't shake the feeling that we were going in circles. It was my traveling companion, Wedge, who broke the awkward silence.
Chief, I see some kind of bright light coming up from ahead.
I turned and saw he had crossed to the opposite cliff. Light, he said. How strange. I didn't see anything out of the ordinary on my side. The sharp rock faces around me blocked out the sun, but Wedge insisted he could see something. Are you thinking what I was thinking, readers? Excitedly, I crossed to where Wedge was standing, dreaming of oasis, or oases, or whatever plural of oasis might await us.
Reporting by Biggs.
So essentially it gives you clues about locations that you can find by following them. The previous one was actually to find a scary ship that you could summon by hitting a bell in the right order and in the right way. I only found one bell in that location, so I might actually need to look back at it again whenever you go to like extra content. But this seems to be like a desert palace that we can find as well. So yep, that's Occult Fan issue 3. Collect them all. That's the whole point. Collect them all, find all the stories. Yeah. Occult Fan in the Final Fantasy VIII game actually led you to finding an alien and ghost train, or not ghost train, doom train, which was pretty interesting, but I don't think we're going to be finding the same things in this. I think it's actually leading us to extra locations that'll be played in the post-game content, I suppose. So, of course, for anybody else who's new to the series or new to the video series, this is like your main hub world where you have a store that you can buy items in and access to a Colosseum and other places. And, of course, check on your mirages that you've already captured in this little box here.
It's mega! A mega mirage!
Can we even use something that big in our stacks?
Well, I wouldn't recommend stacking it on top of you, not unless you want to get squished the flat!
Ooh, ouch. We don't want that. But we could stack on top of them, right?
Uh-huh.
You sure can, but you'll need to use both your powers in battle if you want to summon forth a Mega Mirage. Maybe you've already given it a try, but still...
Yeah, but it was kind of shit.
Don't be afraid to add Mega Mirages to your lineup and test them out in battle.
Sounds good. I'm the kind of guy that learns best in the heat of the moment.
In other words, you hate studying and you won't practice.
Yes, seems like exactly that kind of guy. Alright.
Chocobocolina! Oops! There I go saying it again.
Hi there,
Chocolatte. Chocolatte Mart.
So let's see what items we got for sale that are actually new. It said there would be new items. I'm assuming it's actually mostly referring to these seed items. Drain, sleep, confuse. So those are actually all status effect ones, which would be kind of useful to have. I wouldn't mind getting those skills, but they're quite expensive at 30,000 a pop. Libra, Balance, Cure, Banish, Arrow, Water, Thunder, all the typical ones. What have we got that's actually new here? Oh, so Shell Stones, Protect Stones for casting spells, and what? Dragon Wing? Oh, so Dragon Wing is actually an item that I can buy? Yeah, I'll buy 3 of those. That way I can actually just go and hand them to that dude. Dragon Scale, I can buy 3 of those. Yeah. And that means I can just hand those across for missions. Bam, sorted. Instead of me having to go chase them down. And yeah. Excellent. Yes, I need to buy potions as well. So I'll grab 5 of those. And we'll grab 3 of those. And that kind of covers me for basic kind of like healing and whatever else. Of course, got enough other healing items. I don't want to spend money on remedies, but they're kind of useful. Well, I don't need them now because I have Asuna, which is convenient enough.
Thank you.
No problem. Objectives met, the birthday present. See, so that's objectives met, and that's how I can actually complete these little side quests. I honestly thought they were going to be like rare drop items, but they're actually items that I can just use. So let's see what I get for them. So I get a Berserk Seed. And I get a Arrow Ra seed, so that's actually like a higher level arrow. It's not too bad, pretty cool. And of course I need to defeat 3 cactuars to do that one. I might run into them in the desert here now in a wee bit, so that's not too bad. So, that's like, I kind of like the fact that I don't have to go back to the original location to complete mini-quest side things as long as I pick them up along the way. But, yeah, bam, sorted, done. That's all I really need to come here to do. And I can use this to teleport myself to wherever I need to be. The girl's tea room. Let's take a little quick side trip to the girl's tea room to see what champions that are available. You have to do side missions to do the champions quests. I got the Sephiroth gem for medal for free because it's part of the DLC content. But let's see what I can do to intervene in some of these.
Whose soul will you touch?
I don't want to touch anybody's soul, but I would mind. Whoa! Okay. That caught me off guard. Rhea's an ice bridge. So I'm assuming with these ones that actually have the, whenever I do these ones, they actually have like a question mark. It's actually unlocking a particular item or locking someone that I actually will not see otherwise. So I might go for those. Ooh, resist accuracy down seed. So specifically stops me from losing accuracy. Although if you see that, that's actually defeat the monster living in Big Bridge. Is that a battle on the Big Bridge? Does that mean I would actually be fighting, dropped in on Big Bridge Alexander? Having a blah, talking about the good old days. So that's an Anna Cross story. Right, so what of course, as you can see, it is a really high difficulty one, so I'm assuming it's actually one that you're not meant to do at this point. But we'll take a quick look at one of these. So hunt down some treasure. Riku hatches a ride. So this could be either the Riku one. This one could be Charlotta and Refia. So I'll probably get Refia. Castle Cornelia is an uproar. So the Princess Goblin one. So let's go quickly with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. So I've got 14, but I still have 20. So I've got more Arma gems than I actually have events. Oh, right. So I can spend the Arma gems here to get the get these. Awesome. So yeah, I'm gonna buy Tifa and Refia, and I might swap out one of the ones I currently have. Trading 4 armor gems. Bam! I'm just gonna leave Snow sitting there. I don't care.
What now?
Right. See? So I'm not gonna do the intervene side missions because they'll unlock interesting items and stuff, but I don't really need them for now. I might come back to it as if I need to power level anything. So replace that with Final Heaven. So we have Tifa in there, and we'll take Refia as our third one, and this is actually a healing one. So I've got 2 single attacks, and I have a Restore All, which is going to be useful. Boom. So we just jump out of here again. I'm going to go back to the park. So instead of doing any of these intervene missions, I'm going to keep those probably for excess content after the main story. Because it don't seem to be anything that's actually really absolutely necessary for me to kind of like push through the events. Where we need to go, we need to go back to the caravan. And that's us back to where we need to be. There we go. You see? All done and dusted. And nobody needs me for anything here, so we move on. Oh shit, this guy's still question marking me.
Hey, hey, hey. Just who I was looking for. Sorry to be a bother, but I've got another jobbity job.
Why not? Did he tell me?
So I can make some medicine.
Okie dokie. Can
you spare some time to help a merchant out?
Okie dokie. Let's bring it to the onity. 2 healing springs?
This is what I needy need.
Okay, healing springs. Well, I'll keep an eye out for those in the future. There'll probably be an item that I'll unlock along the way, so convenient enough, I can just complete that mission as needed. So I do have to go back to them to pick up the next mission in a chain, but I don't need to go back to him to actually like trade it, hand it in, which is convenient. I don't mind that. So a little caravan are sitting here.
Always go in prepared.
Of course. Well, this is the way I need to go, but there's another path up there. But let's focus on following the directions
to the Phantom Sand. The shifting sands of the Phantom.
Despite the harsh desert climate, mirages here are full of life.
When did we step into a documentary?
A docu-what?
If you ever get lost in the desert, just follow the light. Think of it as a traveler's tradition.
Okay. Always walk east towards the sun until the sun's overhead, then walk west, and then backtrack the entire way you came. Unintentionally. So where do we need to go? We've got three exits, and none of them marked as the way to go. So, said follow the line. Follow the line. Don't go into the light! I can't help it! It's so beautiful! Okay, so I'm assuming the skulls are the new creature. Are they? So let's get ourselves into combat here. Let's see, what can we do to actually test these guys out? I imagine with it being desert sands, that we're going for water and ice will probably be the better choices. Nut Eater. So these guys are... Also, the Nut Eater is actually not a stack. I thought it was a stack. Is it a stack? Okay, use magical enhancements on the Mirage. Magical enhancements? Okay. Ow. 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 Cheeky sons of bitches. Alright, that's it. Eat it. Okay, that wasn't very effective. Do I have any all-hitting moves? No, I don't. They're all singles. God damn it. Alright, so, let's attack and see if we can do enough damage. Alright, that one's down but not out. Down you go. Boom. Alright, we'll take these guys down, we'll get down to one of them, and then we'll use a attack, or a magical enhancement that'll stop them from being able to, well, make them prism opportunity. So what we're going to use, we're going to use Protect. It's a magical enhancement, and we'll put it on him. Boom. Prism opportunity! Nope, not enough. Alright, we need to do it again. Oh, no! God damn it, that wasn't what I was meant to do. He's a dumb myself. Right. So, let's attack. I'm sure to see what... Did I just use the wrong part? Oh, are you kidding me? Does this help? No, that didn't work. So I need to actually use Protect on this guy. At two levels, it was enough. Sweet. So with the stack of protect on him, it was enough to actually be able to capture him.
That wasn't so bad.
So this is just another Reaver move. It's essentially it's an alternate transfiguration. So essentially, I've unlocked that type of move now. But I'm not going to keep this guy around with me. So I've got a name for this in my head, but I don't know if we'll actually be able to use it. So I need to think of a way to work around it. So, let's go over this. A relative of the Moo that continually munches on a skull-shaped nut can heal itself with a nutty bite. Wait, what's this? It's the one that carved the nut into a skull. Dude! Okay, so, name your Mirage. What I'm thinking, with the positioning of the creature and the fact that it's riding on the skull, this one should be called Skullfucker. Ah, Skullfucker, you dastardly moo you. Okay, so including sex is not allowed, so I need to think of another name instead of Skullfucker. Skull Lover. Skull Lover. There we go. Aww. So sweet, isn't it? It's just a lot less offensive. And we will not be taking you with me. You'll be staying back with Seraphie, where she'll deal with the fact that you're a skull lover. Living in her case. Oh, that she knows. So. It's not telling me which way is the way to go. It's just telling me it's kind of off that direction. So I'm going to take the farthest right gate to take me in that direction, I hope. Still no.
Oh, they all connect in the same path. So we'll just keep on the right-hand side here. Running down the path we run, running down the path. Some people complain about linearity in Final Fantasy 13. So what have we got to fight now? Well, it looks like a scorpion dragon on top of a... What do you call those again? I can't remember what I called mines. We'll find out. We'll kill one of them and we'll knock the other one down. We'll go with... Conquer Drill. Nope, that wasn't good enough. We'll go with Abyss on this one then. Boom! Weak against Dark. Oh, I'm being poisoned. I hate you so much. So much. But that's convenient. Useful to get a brand new skill that's actually going to solve the bother of all those things. What? It was weak, but it did no damage? That's really shitty. Boom. Let's try that again. Boom. Also, it actually has a chance to cause damage. Sometimes it won't. That's not exactly smart. So we'll scan you now. Well, what we'll do is we'll actually put you to sleep first. Convenient. And Libra. Alright, so it's not got that much health, so we need to be careful about knocking it down. So we'll take a couple of turns to build up our buttons or... Actually, if I siphon it, does it wake it up? That's not what I'm curious about. Nope, doesn't. Sweet. So, what I need to do is knock this thing down. Very high chance of knockdown, but also very high chance of miss. So let's see how this goes. Boom! Low topple strength, medium topple strength. Right, let's see. And down it goes! Alright, so we need to actually find out very quickly what affects these ones. Alright, so he has to be the last one standing. And that one needs to be poisoned. Okay, so... See, if I poison him, I'm going to kill him because of the strength of the attack. So I have to actually cure him to poison him. Ugh. Oh, well, it's nice of him to actually have a Tsunaga. So it means I could actually, if I could learn that skill from him, I could reuse it on all my team. So do I have anything that can poison from here? Actually, do you know if I just use an item, I might be able to get away with it? Wind, poison. Do I have any poison items? Yeah, poison fang, bam. Boom! Oh, god damn it. I'm just going to defend here. I don't know what I can really do about that. Boom, got him. And that's you got as well. Yes! I like it when a plan comes together.
Well,
I really
do.
Gotta catch him all, World of Final Fantasy! Okay. Okay, so a bird that uses its stud beak to vent its frustrations. It pecks when it's peckish, and it pecks when it's not. Sadly, it can't fly, but that doesn't stop it from dreaming. Attempts to use it to bore holes in wood have led to numerous accidents across Grimoire. Alright. So, Cockadrill has Arrow, Chaos Beak, Isunaga, HP, Agility, Accuracy, Safety Bit, Blank Space. I really, really hope it actually had that Isunaga is a Mirror Jewel, which would be really, really cool. But obviously, probably not. Let's see. Let's name him. So, Cockadrill. To be honest, the name... Sorry, I just noticed when I was looking up over at the stream that the camera had shifted slightly from my vigorous foot movement, so I need to actually be very cautious about it. The Cockadrill. With a name like that, it already sounds slightly offensive. So what can we do? Cockadrill. 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 Penny Tunnel? It works. Peni Tunnel. I think, in fact, she kind of has the idea for it. I mean, any better ideas? If you have any better ideas, you can, of course, put them in the thing underneath. There's ability to rename these things at a later point. But for now, I think we'll go a Peni Tunnel. Like a flesh tunnel in a penis. And we'll... He's a medium. Let's see, what mediums do I have to actually swap him out with? STD Bob? I don't really need Isunaga as it is at the moment. So I think I will actually leave it with Seraphie for now. I don't think there's actually anything I really need from him. So this is, what is it called again? I can't remember what the name of this damn thing is called. What is its name? Sandicore. Okay, so it does Sandstorm, Venom Needle, Tickle. Oh, Tickle's probably useful for actually being non-damage unstacking. That's pretty kind of useful. HP, Defense, Magic, Agility, Arenaceous Body? I don't know what that means, but it'd be interesting. Also has Faith, Doom, Great Sandstorm whenever it's leveled up, and Pharmacology Stabilizer. So Stabilizer is useful because it affixes anytime that you actually got wobble. Pharmacology means that healing items work better. So it's got something that actually might be worth leveling up towards, but Sandstorm, Venom Needle, and Tickle? Not really kind of working in my stack at the moment, so I'll probably leave the Santicore to survive. But it's essentially like a scorpion cat. So what are we going to call him? Let's see, what is the stats like? Strength and magic? Low? Worthless. Worthless! Absolutely worthless! So, Nimrod, Sandicore. Sandicore. So it is a scorpion cat. Poison pussy. Or poison puss. Aw, there we go. It fits perfectly too, doesn't it? Poison puss. We're going to leave you with Seraphie as well, chap. What I really need is actually there to be unlocked an ability that to level up the things inside my prism case while I'm actually still... while I'm not using them, because later on in this game, I'm sure I'm going to need some of these skill sets. I'm going to need to level them up, but I'm not going to be able to actually, like, spend the time grinding here on the channel. So there could actually very well be a day where I just go and grind like a motherfucker to see what happens. Okay. So I just ran through a tunnel and it took me back to exactly the same place. So, they said follow the light. Can I follow the light? So, I'm assuming I should be on the left-hand side?
Where did you come from?
Cactar! Hey, buddy! Aw.
That was a good fight.
All right!
Wait a second. Don't I have somebody that has no escape? Let's use that. Also, not destroy my throat while doing it. Okay, so I think it might be Chesty LaRue that has no escape. Is it? Yes, it is. So what would I may have missed out on if I used it on anything else? I'm on level 2. Oh, so I'll use No Escape first and get that, because it means that I can actually then catch those cactars that I want to get. And then I'll save the next 2 points for these board unlocks, because I'm curious to find out what the big version of this is. Yep, we'll just jump right back in there. So hopefully I run into a couple more characters while digging through this particular location. So I've got a feeling that this is repeating itself. Yeah, it is. So I need to go down and then go around the left-hand side, I think. Ah!
I won't hold back.
Right, let's do this.
Oh, a couple of chocobos. So, yeah, a couple of chocobos. What I really need to do is make sure that she has some kind of all ability, because I'm getting annoyed with actually not being able to attack all whenever I wasn't using... Oh, I can switch back to the fire ones now, because... I can switch back to the Charizard, because I don't need to worry about it actually being a water attack that's coming at me. So let's see what we got here.
Abyss. Lay him into the abyss.
Boom! Down you go. And what else have we got here? Thunder, blizzard, thunder, blizzard, thunder, blizzard, thunder, blizzard, thunder, blizzard. We'll go with thunder. Oh, nice counter. And we'll go with thunder again, I suppose, and take out that nutty
dude. I got this.
Down you go. Chocobo? Ah, wasn't enough to take him down. Oh. Chocobo kick must have hit me a couple times there, did they? And we'll hit the Nut Eater with Thunder as well. Oh, wasn't enough. Okay, we need to use a couple of hits of that to take him down. Down you go, buddy.
No trouble at all.
Happy days. Okay, so we've obviously got a little bit of leveling up done there. Okay, let's see. Alright, go up here. I'm just going to heal up my characters because I'm a little bit concerned about running into the wrong things here. Actually, you know what I'll do? I'll switch first. Boom. Let's see if I actually can do a little bit quicker damage. Oh, although it takes away my, what's this now? I'm probably going to run into a cactar, aren't I? I'm going to run into a cactar, right?
It's here cactar.
No, it doesn't. Ah, fair enough. There's a couple of things I can just beat the crap out of, because I've already got the one of each of these. Oh, he doesn't have enough power to do water harmony.
Ooh, well done.
But she definitely has.
Die in the flames of death!
I got this!
God damn it! That's why I counter every single attack now. That's pretty convenient though. So, does this work? No, that doesn't work. Oh wow! Oh shit! Yeah, heal yourself. Heal yourself. Why do you not have enough to heal yourself? Oh, come on. Right, well, this'll do for now. That's a pretty decent heal, to be honest. Thunder doesn't work on them. Abandon Flame doesn't work on them. I was probably better sticking with Dark. I'm going to have to switch back to those other ones again, because that wasn't really doing great for me. Fire, Fira. These are all fire attacks. Right. This is a terrible, terrible choice. I shouldn't have actually switched back across. Alright, I need to throw an ether on you. Where are you? Ethers, there you are. Ba-ba-bow, ba-ba-bow. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm siphoning one of you guys because it'll. Oh, weak against that? Alright. Obviously, he's weak against darkness. That's why. So, Water Harmony. Do the damage. Are you. What? What just happened there? Screw this. Let's see what happened whenever we threw the tripod in. He's had a little bit more time to level up, but yeah. I'm not doing much damage here, and I need to actually have someone that does something a little bit different, so let's try something a little bit different. Let's try something that might actually hit more than a few of them. Ice Storm on both. Yeah, did okay damage, but not brilliant. We'll try Sonic Fangs Lightning on both. Nope, not quite where we wanted. Oh, wow. Well, not really doing too much damage, though. It's not doing a second set of damage attacks. Yeah, this is not working, but at least I can focus the damage on one of them and not run out of all that immediately. We've got two left, so let's just release that and go back to what we need. Because that way we actually have a little bit of this left. And we almost got him beat. And I can immediately siphon off someone from one of these guys at least. Attack, and... Oh, no, not the one I wanted to hit. Not the plan at all. What am I doing? I could just punch this thing to death. Boom, boom. 400 damage. Down you go. Should have been doing this from the start and just beating him down. Why? Oh, see, I don't like the fact that sometimes they just completely mitigate damage. Yeah. Stop mitigating damage and putting it down to zero. I know I hit you.
So bad.
I'm not cool with that. Makes my fight longer and more of a pain in the hole. So, I need to use a heal on both of these characters now. Light potion. One. Two. Alright, that's these both healed. Switching you back to your other stack. And bam. Ready, rock and roll again. Oh, yes, that's right. I need to check the Mirage boards too. Spend the ones on Tripod for a start because... Oh, hang on. Sorry, folks. I actually need to take an interruption because of an audio issue. That's completely unprofessional. I didn't turn off alarms on a phone. Right, we're back. Sorry about that. So yeah, I didn't think that'd be one of the first things you actually think about, to make sure you actually turn off all audio alarms that are going to be interrupting. So, I don't have... I could spend 1 point and unlock that transfiguration, so what does that do? Oh, right. So I can use that to turn into a Fenrir. That's nice. So I can ride a Fenrir, can't I? That's kind of cool. So now a rideable. But also means I can go into those other setups and do the stats of that one. So yeah, boom, 3, 6, and then I'm going to have 2 left. Cool. That's those ones done. And then I'll just leave that for the moment. So what can I do in Fenrir? Just see what his abilities are. Fenrir is Ice Storm, Howling Moon. Oh, Howling Moon's actually healing. Or a stat boosting tool. Sled Fang. Joyride, First Strike. Oh, that's kind of cool. So if I actually go back and pick up some of these ones, like from the White Knack Fenrir and stuff, it'll level up the powers of my Cerberus as well. Useful skills. So, yes, Mirage Boards. Is this actually at the point now where I can use them to be ridden on? Nah, not really. Come back to you later, Marbro. You're an interesting man. No. Oh, I better spend some points on this one because it's actually like sitting at 26. It'll level up a little bit. Is there any gems? No, there's no mirror jewels in this guy. Alright. But you can do stats effects. So if I go up this way, I can get to this one first. I already unlocked that. So I need to get across that as fast as possible. If I go a straight line, I should have done that. 4, 4, 3, that's 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, so. Oh, I need to have an item to do that one. Bugger. That was a complete waste of it. Right, so we've just got a lot of stats effects in this one, so we can take those on board. And fill these out. Yeah, so essentially I'm almost maxing out that board just with him there. I can probably drop him because I don't really have anything I can level him into yet. Because I don't have the item for whatever it is. So the next time I catch something, I know who I'm dropping. I don't need to keep STD Bob around anymore. I just want to get rid of my STDs, really. So where were we? We've got them all set up the way we want them to. And I hope this is the right way to go. Alright, so cool. We're into a different path here. So, it said follow the light, which appears to be...
Ray? That creepy noise that we've been hearing? I think it's getting the opposite of not less quieter.
Excuse me?
Of not less quieter?
As in, it's coming closer. It's coming for us, blah, blah, blah.
I guess we're doing this.
So this is going to be interesting. He can't run. I don't know if he'll even try to run. That's the problem. So let's see what we need to do to catch a cactar. Inflict slow. Okay. Holy shit, did he just heal? Alright, so we need to do something that costs slow. Confusion. Oblivion. Berserk. Confusion. Remove slow. I don't have anything that actually causes slow. Son of a... Right. So... all I can do is fight him. And I should have looked at... Oh, I didn't even look to see what bloody affects him. Alright. Well, I'm assuming water is not going to affect him too much. I imagine Scar probably going to be fire. So I will go with thunder. Maybe darkness? Well, he's dead anyway.
That wasn't so
but yeah,
bad.
I need to have something that actually affects slow on him, which, I want a cactar. I actually do want a cactar. I managed to catch the smaller version of the cactar in another game in an earlier location, which isn't, which means I know it exists, but, I couldn't bring it across because it was on a different save game on a different version of the game on the PS Vita. But I know what he can, know what other ones he can be. But I know like Thousand Needles is a really nice move.
It's getting late. We're taking too long.
We better get the clear of here before the sun goes down.
Yeah, actually, if we don't, there's no light to lead us.
Come on.
God damn it. Oh god, this is gonna be interesting. Right, so thunder. On the Nut Eater. If I cast Thunder on it, I can knock it down before we even start doing problems. He's gone. Boom! Retaliation. I don't mind retaliations. What the fuck? What happened? What the fuck? Whoa, 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 whoa! What the hell happened there? Yes, bring everybody the fuck back. I was unbelievably puzzled there. It seemed to actually, like, one of my guys attacked me at one point, and I was going, like, wait. Hey, you... I think my box used armor piercer against me in confusion. That is fucked up. Okay, so, yeah. Just, I was confused there for a second. So, Chocobo. Goodbye. Chocobo. Go down. Stay down. Don't like your multiple kicking attacks here. See ya. Same thing with crocodiles. Or chocodiles or... Whoa! What the fuck are they doing that's knocking me out so bad? Do they have, like, death beaks? So I'm completely puzzled about how they were doing so much damage to me.
Predictable.
Why did that fight end up being a lot harder than I expected? That scared the crap out of me.
We better get the bitches clear of here before the sun goes down.
Yeah, this is the way I'm meant to be going. Follow the light. Follow the light. I was wondering, was that a chest down there or something else? I'm squinting at the screen whenever it's actually, like, in good quality. I don't know why I can't see it. Alright, so... yeah. Beating the shit out of these things as fast as humanly possible. Stop doing... Right, so they're doing like 100. Just stop mitigating my damage, you son of a bitch! Wow, that is actually driving me slowly around the fucking bend. Actually, like, that's going to make me really, really goddamn angry. Topple, you fucks. That is fucking it. Go down! Chaos Beak seems I must have, like, an instant death chance. Which is not cool. Not cool at all. Chaos Beak causes confusion. That's the reason why I end up attacking myself. Okay. I can figure that be the case. Girl, away, whatever the fuck you are. I'm still gonna kick your ass. Why have I got a feeling... Whoa, oh, there's a chest. Why have I got a feeling like this entire area must be like one giant dragon, possibly? Yes. This is where we'd like to save. Normally I don't save mid-chapter. It's one of the things where I don't feel the absolute need to. But in this case, I'm not risking it, just because of that, like, one quick scare we got out of absolutely nowhere. And I still want to find my two more cactuars in this area before we move on, so that'll be nice. Stop nibbling my nuts, you son of a bitch! Down you go, nut biter. He's a nut botherer, that's exactly what he is. Just going on an investigation with the possible chance of seeing... Oh no! No! Oh, I was worried there for a second. I thought I was actually going to not lose track of where I was going to be. I'm going to have to backtrack around and come up. So whatever this is, it's loud as fuck. It's a sandworm. Sandworm, don't you hate him? Oh, whoa. Oh yeah, I really do hate him.
Oh my gosh. How many of them are wriggling around down there?
Too many.
Well, whatever the answer is, don't tell me!
Oh god, that's disgusting. That is kind of disgusting.
These things have been under us the whole time?
Yeah.
More than you can possibly imagine.
Ah, I said don't tell me about it!
I don't want to know how disgusting they are! Sandworms.
Okay.
We're gonna do hate them. Unpresentable. Weak against ice. Good. Weak against air. Weak against water. So, looks like it's going to be ice and physical that we're going to be taking them down with. Nice and physical, what else has it got? They're strong against everything, so I can't really hit them with anything else. So darkness works and ice is going to work. That's my two options for attacks. Right. Ice and dark, between the ones that, the weapons I've got, that's what I'm using. So blizzard. Down you go. Ow. 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 Okay. This isn't really going to be working too well. Water harmony it is. I think it's going to have to be water harmony from him. Hmm. This might help. Nope, did absolutely none. She's gonna have to be throwing ethers on him, isn't it? That's what I think I'm gonna have to do. I'm gonna have to actually throw ether after ether on him so he can continue doing his attack. And anytime they attack, she's going to get a nice sneaky counter in, which is working for me. Don't like the fact that it's completely random who it hits and how many it hits. This might actually even up the scores a little bit. We're going to go for it. We're going for final heaven. And on the biggest guy there. Tifa, save us! This is kind of cool. Nice.
Final heaven.
Nice and powerful looking. 2,000 damage, that's not too bad. Also updated all my stats to make me stronger. Works for me. What was I going with there? Water harmony, yeah. Screw that, I'm going to take this guy down. I'm going to actually focus on just him. I think I can probably force him down pretty damn quick here if I do push at this. Oh, go down, you son of a bitch. Uh-oh. Alright. Go down, you son of a bitch! There we go. Alright, so maybe it's time to focus a second one. So, we don't need to worry about T healing just yet. We'll save that one for just in case emergency. Sephiroth or Tifa again?
Place your bets now!
No, I really do. Like, Tifa looked kind of interesting, but the music's nowhere near as cool as Sephiroth. Sephiroth is a badass. And this is a guaranteed effect going like, yeah. Yes. You can end your own with your supernovas. This is the fact that it is a pre-rendered cutscene, so you never get to see the combat actually attacking the enemy. They put this in as a post-DLC kind of thing. But I love the idea that they could keep doing this, keep adding DLC champions to have it. That's pretty powerful. Oh, it made me stronger too again. Uh-oh. Yeah, you're going to need to do some healing, Jap. Oh, unless, actually, no, she can do it to herself. High potion. On her.
Okay.
She's going to get toppled as well soon. I think, is there anything I can actually do that might actually be worthwhile? But no, there's actually literally nothing. Unless Armor Piercer actually works on this guy. And it didn't bring him down in any way, shape, or form. Wait, did that do like 912 damage? Holy shit! That was like one of the most powerful attacks I've ever used in this game so far, with like a single character striking outside of being a champion. Crap. Just punch him in the face. Oh, that's why, because I've got the boost from all the champions I used. Nice. Nice. That was a very quietly confident beatdown at the end there. Like, whatever caution that I had was completely gone as soon as I realized, like, oh, wait, I can punch him for 1,000. So, armor gems, Gaia drums, earth hammers. So, of course, I've unlocked somebody else, or I've got armor gems to do more side missions. Good news. Very good news.
Are you trying to get killed?
Huh?
What? Oh, shit. Ha! Doom, 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 doom.
I won't make it.
Yeah, I think we're grand.
What just... Whatever. I'll take it.
All right, so as a medium, she just got powered up from the light of our things. Lightning strikes! Did you get a new sword? Hi, Lightning!
I don't know what you did.
You're one of the most hated protagonists of a Final Fantasy series. How does it feel? Also, you looked fantastic in the Dolce & Gabbana's.
What?
Time to go!
Come on!
Right!
Got it!
You don't run, you float! Well, at least we're safe and sound.
I just want to forget those sandworms ever existed.
You and me too, brother. You and me too.
No mark of where I am. So, I'll probably go and talk to this dude as well.
The moon is a thing of beauty tonight.
Oh, that's true. It is looking quite gorgeous.
Surprising. I never thought the giants from the hills
would have so much trouble crossing a desert.
Oh, so then you've heard of us.
Why are you so happy about that? Trust me, we do not want fame.
Nah, kind of a little bit. Just a little bit of fame. Just a teeny tiny bit.
We made it from cactars. They'll get you high.
And with the little explanation of the story pop-up, we now know that she's told them everything.
The keys from the prophecy? Interesting. That explains some things.
Hmm? So you've heard of them? I don't suppose you can tell us more.
There are four. Earth, fire, water, and shadow, if I remember correctly.
Earth, fire, water, shadow?
You also happen to know where the keys are hidden.
Is something wrong?
Oh, sorry. I've never heard exactly where the keys might be hidden. But listen.
I might know something about that.
Who's this?
Really? The key of Earth lies in the cradle of Mako's light. The key of tides, that one lies in the temple in the deep. The key of shadows lies in the land of naught but night.
Oh, that sounds nice and specific.
But what does that mean?
The Crimson Prophecy's missing verse?
Yes. You know much, traveler. Time out. What is this missing verse?
They say that part of the original prophecy was omitted from subsequent copies. However, to be able to read that...
Oh, I haven't read it myself. I heard it from someone who has.
And Bahamut's castle?
Third-party information is not very useful.
Probably don't know that much.
How would she know where that is? I don't know. But there are whispers. What?
Super seriously? Helpful!
This is merely a rumor, but... They say the castle you seek, the domain of the heralds and their king, lies past the Crystal Tower, beyond the path of the gods.
Okay. Heralds. So we keep having to go to this Crystal Tower people keep telling us about?
The king who founded Bahamut.
Cool. So, all we have to do is get those four keys, and then haul Heine over to the Crystal Tower, am I right?
Move those buttocks.
From the sound of it...
All this reassuring info is making me sleepy.
Aww.
Don't yawn, Lon. You're making me yawn, too.
What do you say we just... turn in here for the day.
Yeah, okay.
You were drugged!
Good night, brain.
Good night.
Is it not suspicious that they just, like, passed out like that? Yay, cutscene time! I do like these animation cutscenes. Lightning looks ridiculous.
What is that noise?
Now what?
Somebody's pulling the plug on the sand pit! Or this is... Oh! That right, with the chains, it's actually the bad guys, isn't
Federation.
It? Federation.
What are they doing here?
We've come to destroy you.
Oh, well, there's a castle. Is this what you came for, Lightning? What for you came to destroy?
The drinks last night.
What? They were...
Dude, my body...
I knew it was a poison!
I can barely... No heroics, please.
Whoa! Not good. So wait, is Edgar a bad guy?
No. There's certainly no way for us to treat a lady.
I'm trying to remember what Edgar's from.
As I frequently say, the churl never gets the girl.
Right.
Rubbish.
Who's the knight?
The Federation. Who else could it be?
I believe our arrangement said the giants were mine to attend to.
Attend to? That sounds awfully churlish to me.
I didn't say I wasn't one.
You may be a giant, but my attention I say for real grown-ups.
That's it. Nobody talks to her like that.
Lon!
Okay.
Let's try to keep things civil, if you don't mind. Please don't struggle.
What is going on?
This sucks.
I don't know.
Interesting way to end a chapter. Huh. Right. That was intriguing. I wanted to know more about these heralds that have actually been attacking. Obviously, we've been captured at the end of this bit, so what happens next, I do not know. But obviously, guys, you need to come back for the next episode, the next chapter, chapter 14, to find out what the fuck just happened. So obviously, our thingy's not working. We are being poisoned. We've been captured. We probably have to escape. I just hope it's not as bad as the prison escape from Final Fantasy VIII, because that was unbelievably annoying and slow. But yeah, guys, thank you very much for watching. This has been Chapter 13 of World of Final Fantasy.
World of Final Fantasy.
The World of Final Fantasy. The World of Final Fantasy. Thank you very much for watching. And if you wanted, enjoyed it, you can hit the subscribe button right up here, or you can go and check out other episodes in the series and other shows that I've been working on lately in the boxes on the side. And I want to say thank you very much for watching. Make sure you come back, and I will see you all in the next episode. Bye-bye.